In order to do a standard deviation calculation using your calculator, which is the preferred method when you go to take your tests, you want to take advantage of a function inside the calculator called 1varstats. Now, to use 1varstats, the first thing that you have to do is give a data set to your calculator. And you'll do that through the list editor. So if you hit the stat key and then click edit, press enter that is, then you'll get into the list editor and you can put your data into a list. Now, I've already started this data into a list just to save some time, but this is a pretty short list anyway, so I'll put the last two in, 10 and 29. If you're not sure how to enter data into a list, go into your textbook. There's some links to videos that will help you out. Now, to get this standard deviation, we'll quit out of the list editor, hit the stat key again, and this time we're going to the function 1varstats. Highlight that, press enter. Now, some of you may see the function 1varstats show up on the home screen. If you have the older operating system calculators, that's what you'll see. Some of you with the newer operating system may see something that says like frequency list, something like that. Just you wait just a second, and I will show you exactly what to do in that instance. All right, so for those of you who's seeing exactly what I'm seeing, this is what you would do next. Now, 1varstats needs to just know where the data is. So you can tell it by pressing second, and if you hit 1, if you'll notice right above the 1, it says L1. So that's how you reference a list. Just press second and then the button that corresponds to the number of the list that you put your data in. It will, by default, use the data in L1, so if you don't tell it anything, it will just use the data in L1, but it's a good practice to go ahead and tell it where the data is. Once you do that, you'll get your answers. SX is your sample standard deviation. So sample standard deviation is SX. The population standard deviation comes up as sigma X. These are being asked to be round to two decimal places. So the sample standard deviation is 6.83, and the population standard deviation is 6.24. And that's all you need to do to find standard deviations on your tests. Now, for those of you who have a later model operating system, TI-84 plus and above, let me show you what you may be running into. All right, I will put some data into the list. Okay, and now if I go out of the list editor and I press stat and come over here to 1varstats, then I get this menu right here. What this is doing is it's trying to help you know what kind of inputs are possible to your function. So for instance, in the calculator, you will type on the home screen the function 1varstats and then give it the list where your data is, right? And it's possible to also give it a frequency list. You'll learn about that later on. Now, it's basically saying, okay, where is your data? Where are your frequencies? And if you don't have frequencies, just leave that blank. Then hit calculate. And what it does, if you look real quick, it showed the 1varstats L1 on screen. So it's just kind of a little helper system to make things a little bit easier for you so you don't have to remember what menu options are where. But if you want to make the calculator look like what you see on screen, you can do that. If you press the mode key and scroll down to the second set of output and find Stat Wizards. If you set the Stat Wizards to off, from there forward, your calculator will operate just like the TI-83 does. And my preference is for students to go ahead and do that. Then later on, when you're a little bit more confident with how the calculator works, turn them on because they are helpful, but understand the core functionality first, and then go and turn that stuff on later.